the hell's Bog? Speak to Bog? I have a mission now. You want me to talk to this guy?
You want to kick
nothing like the smell of a dead shark after you cook him with an energy blast.
Are you shooting sharks? Speak to, is that a, that might be an activity. Speak to Bog. Let's talk to Bog first. He's here, right? These guys can wait for their galloping crap. I'm gonna talk to Bog.
So there I am. You see,
there you are. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Tell someone who cares. Oh, he's in Last Nova. So is Bog getting some grog?
We call UCC's death shush, but to the fleet, they're just bait.
Oh yeah, that's fascinating. So I've talked to Bog already.
Get you a drink?
Yeah, I've asked him this stuff. I didn't ask him. What's on the menu?
Bog's grog and anything else your heart desires.
What is Bog's grog? I thought I was being clever. Huh. They're still playing black metal. Love it. I was gonna say, what doesn't fit in with all this stuff? Toast. Although they have a sandwich also. Alright. I wish you've been moping around, Bog. No one likes a sad bartender.
Working around this day in day out.
Crying in your pretzels.
They wouldn't give a damn.
Crying in your beer. Well, you listen to our problems, so let me listen to yours. You talk louder.
I guess I'm thinking of my dear old Maddie. The only woman I ever loved.
Madeline Pryor?
Almost married her, I did. I missed my chance and lost her to one of my best mates.
Oh, I thought it was Scott Summers.
If you want to help an old man out, bring me back the one thing of Maddie's that ever meant anything to me. Her ring.
Her ring? What's the story here, though?
Maddie had my eye back in the day. Thing was, she had the eye of my best mate, too. A bloke by the name of Clay Dietrich.
Oh.
Clay and I had a luxury liner. Snatched a ring I knew Maddie would love.
You both did?
Before I could say anything, Clay asked if he could have it and needed to propose. Long story short, Clay married Maddie and me. Ran off to raise hell in Ecliptic. And then he got the poor girl killed.
Oh, damn. You really not need to talk louder, though, because you're playing black metal here, and you're, like, mumbling. Hi. Look like you walked out of Cyberpunk 2077. What has this guy done for me, right? Alright, I got the ring, but I better get paid. Better be getting paid for this.
Of course. Don't think I ain't got a clue about who I'm dealing with, mate.
What's that mean?
Clay showed up on my radar a bit ago. Probably why I'm in a bigger rut than usual.
Mm.
I'll send you the details. I don't care how you do it. Just get that ring back.
Okay, I will.
Clay better not have done anything with that ring.
Can you tell me more about Maddie?
Madeleine
LaRue.
The only woman I'd ever loved. She was life itself. Funny, impulsive, quick-witted, and even quicker with a gun.
Mm.
I met her back when we were only kids, I did. Doing small jobs just to get by. Clay and I both had a thing for her. I never should have made the first move. Who knows if Maddie and I would have made it. But I bet she'd still be alive. running with the fleet.
Sounds like she made the wrong choice.
You're damn right she did. But I'm the fool that let it happen.
Yeah, free will, you know, we're gonna do. Is there anything I need to know about Clay?
Only that I won't be shedding any tears should he meet an unsightly end.
Well, naturally.
The man only cares about himself. To think I spent all those years sticking my neck out for him, he never learned a damn thing.
Learned how to screw you over. It seems he says anything different. What's the deal with the ring?
I found that ring on a luxury liner heist. I pulled off with Clay. The moment I saw it, I knew it was for my money. I would have given it to her too if Clay hadn't beaten me in a punch. I never should have let him have it. I should have let them both know exactly how I felt.
Yeah. He said it in a little different way this time. And under here, I'll skip past it, but there was some more options here.
Madeleine, she was like, I met her back when we were, who knows if that.
Right, see all these options under here. So Maddie was a member of the Crimson Fleet?
Yep. All three of us joined up together. Got recruited when we ran into some fleet who were after the same target. The moment we set foot inside the key, we knew we were home. Only Clay had to go and screw things up with a damn new office.
Why didn't you ever tell her how you felt?
Clay was my best friend. As long as the two of them seemed happy, I was ready to respect that and keep my feelings to myself.
Aw.
Of course, I always knew it would last, and then I'd have my chance sooner or later.
Oh, okay.
Which is why I planned on holding on to that ring to begin with.
Okay. Why do you think she'd still be alive if she chose you over Clay? Because Clay's an idiot and got her killed, I guess?
If Maddie wasn't with Clay, she would have stuck with the fleet. Probably would have been a captain by now. She was that good. Instead, Clay got him wrapped up with Ecliptic and sealed her fate the moment he started running his damn mouth again.
Alright. Got it.
Not a day goes by when I don't regret not saying something to her. Yeah, but it's too late now.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll see you next time.
Tina! Hi.
Hey, Cap. You hiring? Got some baddies on my tail, and I need a place to lay low.
I would lay low here, then. Sorry, I can't help you right now.
Nah, no hard feelings. Life's tough enough without taking on someone else's enemies. I'll be around if you change your tune.
I really like her accent, so...
Need something?
I might... Need something? I might take her up on that offer. Well, you got a system error. You look like my computer. Only blue and with a frowny face. A side frowny face. Emoticon smiley thingy. Alright, so this says... Reclaiming the past. Bog asked me to recover a ring that belonged to a woman he loved from a man named Clay Dietrich. I need to travel to the deserted Ecliptic garrison on Gunnyboo 6A in the Gunnyboo system and retrieve it. Who the hell would name their system that? Yeah, I know. Gunnyboo. That's a great name. Love it. Alright, so we are now... We're not doing that now, obviously. We are doing, oh, it just switched to it. Alright. Or I never switched to it in the first place.
Look at the state of this place. It's amazing the key is still in one piece.
Yeah. I mean, inside it's made of a whole bunch of pieces that are all, dirty and smelly and stuff. Alright. 45 minutes. So far, so good. Did I press that? Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna do that every now and then. Because if the system crashes now, my files are saved. At least from when I just did that. So...
Yeah?
We need to go up. Funny, it's not pointing us to an elevator, it's just... It's just going like, yeah, go fly up there. Operation center? I can't stand her, but I'll talk to her first because she's not the target.
The fleet's the only family you need.
Okay, then I'll talk to him.
Your buddy Rokoff is aboard the key. Told me everything had happened.
Okay.
Yeah, he won't shut up about you. Keeps going on and on. Now I remember why we kicked his ass out the fleet.
Oh, he wants to come back in. He wants to rejoin the fleet. Well, Rokoff made me do everything, but at least we got what we wanted.
Still a lazy old bastard, huh? Can't say I'm surprised.
Might have learned from you.
That's not exactly filling me with confidence, Rook, so I'm going to leave it up to you. Is Rokoff in or is he out?
He's gonna give me flack for saying this. What's back there? Oh, person. I say he's out, but we should pay him for his work on this job. Yeah, I don't want him joining and having to deal with him.
Huh. Interesting. You think it's worth wasting credits on the guy?
Wasting?
It's not even worth wasting a bullet on Rokoff.
If Rokoff had anything to do with putting this information about Crix's legacy in our hands, then I say cut him in for a taste. You don't like it, Naeva? Too bad.
Yeah, it wouldn't do it for nothing.
Speaking
right?
of which, let me see that data you copied from the Galbank archives.
Please?
Ah, so the Galbank transport went down over Bannock 4.
Oh, you can read.
Bannock.
I didn't know that.
Why does that sound familiar?
Kidding.
Naeva?
Yeah, keep your panties on. I'm looking it up.
Oh, you can read too. You guys are so impressive.
I got it. Bannock 4. Let's see.
It's actually being decent to me right now.
Bannock 4 is an EM class gas giant. We can't even get a ship near the thing without frying every circuit aboard.
EM class? Impossible. There isn't a ship in operation that can navigate that type of interference.
Oh, boy. I hope I never run into that kind of an interference. Gotta be a way to an end. EM class gas giant?
Don't know that one, huh?
Electromagnetic?
Well, pick up your pencil. There's gonna be a test on this later.
You guys use pencils?
EM class means the planet is giving off a ridiculously high amount of electromagnetic radiation.
Right.
We're talking off the charts here. Fly your ship anywhere near one of these death traps, and you'll blow every single circuit on your ship. You'd be dead in space. Get it?
Dead space. All right. Well, there's gotta be a way.
Yeah, sure. We'll just wrap your ship in a ton of copper and launch you right in there. That ought to do the trick, right?
I think I'll pass.
Both of you shut up and think for a second. I'm sure Crix hit the same roadblock. All we need to do is figure out how he got around it.
Find more of his locks.
This sounds like a goddamn waste of time to me.
What about her award? Oh, right. He doesn't know about that, right? He doesn't know that she wants this award, so she's going to hit me up on the down low to give it to her. Crix want to go... Maybe the data's wrong? No, Crix wouldn't have given up.
That's the spirit, Rook. That is the essence of the Crimson Fleet that has been slipping away lately. Naeva, the Galbank data says the transport had a CBR-27 transponder.
Right.
Can we track that kind of thing? Pinpoint its exact location?
That transponder is military grade. We're talking
ultra bit encryption. Constantly reshuffling frequencies.
Ultra bit encryption.
We don't have shit like that laying around.
It did say that.
But before you get that pissy look on your face, I heard that the UC's been working on a ship signal decryption system called the comm spike.
Oh.
We grab that little beauty, and we'll be able to track anything you want.
Oh, good. What's his name?
All right, here is the plan, so shut up and listen.
Hey.
Rook, I want you and Naeva to put your heads together and get us that comm spike. I don't care if it's mounted at the top of mast. I want it. In the meantime, I'm going to find out more about this EM class gas giant problem. And I think I know just who to ask.
Who?
Give me a little time to crunch the numbers on the comm spike with Jazz, and I'll point us in the right direction.
So this is good. The UC has it. So I can just go to the UC Vigilance and be like, yeah, they want this thing. He'll just give it to me. Here you go. And it's that easy. And meanwhile, I'll make up a story being like, yeah, I had to fight like 10,000 pirates just to get this thing.
You better start talking.
Oh, 10,000. 10,000 of you. I don't think she would like that very much. You don't give up easy, do you?
We do or we die. That's the way Cricks did things. And that is the way we should have been doing it for years. It's as simple as that.
Okay. We'll figure this out. Promise.
I promise? You gonna write that in your diary, little girl?
Okay, I'm starting not to like you again.
That is enough! We are in arm's reach of Crix's legacy, and I don't have time to deal with this kind of bullshit.
I know, me too, right?
Now, both of you, get the hell out of here and get to work.
All right. Let's get this over with. Follow me.
I can't get that thing, that device, with you here.
We'll have the whole settled systems on the run someday.
Oh, yeah. What's it say now? After reporting my actions on the Siren of the Stars to Delgado, Naeva wants me to follow her and then speak to her about the Earth Savior Award. She didn't say that. She did not say that. But is what I figured. I can't go the way that way. Whoop. Lead the way. Kick buckets too. Kicking that one.
If you need credits, hit up the mission boards at the core.
I'll do something else, thank you. Go. You're hopping around. Jazz only. I never noticed it said that.
You've got stuff to smuggle. I've got the stuff to hide it. Here to upgrade that ship of yours?
Imagine asking her this with Naeva right here. I think I've asked that already before, though.
See you around.
All right. Let's get right to it. Did you get the Earth Savior Award, or am I going to be very disappointed?
What's Jazz doing here? That's a stupid question. We're in her freaking shop. Why do I have the feeling you're gonna make more money off of this thing than I am?
Well, that's because you'd be absolutely right. Hmm. You see, everyone above you in the fleet is making more than you are off the same gig. That's why we're all fighting our way to the top. Mm. Understood? Good. Now, you might want to hand over that award before I have you tossed off the key. Just a thought.
I kind of want to shoot you right in the forehead, but here you go.
Well, well, look at that. You followed my directions, and now you're going to end up with some credits in your pocket.
Whoopee.
That about does it then. hell of a deal for both of us, I'd say. Anyway, here's your cash. Keep this up, and I might even start respecting you. All right, Fleet? We've all got work to do, so let's get to it.
Oh, okay, good. Now I can go to the UC Vigilance.
Better get a move on before Dale sees you slacking.
I'm gonna kill her before this is done, or when this is done. Alright, so now... I've gained all the information I can regarding the Galbang Transport Legacy and its location at Bannock 4. I should now return to the Vigilance and report my findings to Commander Ikande. And then he'll give me that thing. Whatever it's called. The thing to decrypt the transponder. Right? We're decrypting the transponder? Drop all your stuff.
Only one point of Moera's patrol route to work from. That's how it goes sometimes.
You said you have something interesting for me.
I thought you'd never ask. Here.
Your face is up there. Yeah. I guess you gave me something?
Ask whatever you'd like.
I've already asked those. What'd you give me?
Bye.
Moving very strangely. Something just flew by. Oh, there's like debris out there. Oh, it's part of the space station. Oh, there is debris out there. Look at that. So what did you give me? New item? Well, I know I picked that up. Did she give me a stimulant? I don't remember picking up a stimulant. Alright, whatever then. Thank you for the stimulant route thing. What ship is that? Me hailing, not you. All right, let's... So we can travel from here. Well, that's where the UC Olympus is now? All right. But it always powers it down. I guess that's just the way it is. Right. is over there. Already at this. Oh, I'm there. Alright. We're there, dude. Oh, yes, this. No. Open hailing frequencies.
Vessel ID acknowledged. Port 1 cleared for docking. Welcome home to the Vigilance.
Thank you, sir. It's an interesting cinematic. It looks like, you know, actual.
Commander Ikande runs a tight ship, so I suggest we be on our best behavior.
I mean, that part, it doesn't look like it's a video game, if that makes any sense to you. You're acting very strange. I'm gonna save. I'm gonna restart the recording. 1 hour. Locked in. Stuck sometimes.
Vigilance is a state-of-the-art.
So I heard there was a bit of excitement on the Siren of the Stars. Your handiwork, I assume?
Who else? Some of the passengers to be arrested. News travels fast around here, huh?
We told you we'd be keeping tabs on you. So, did you get information for us or not?
You're keeping tabs, you would already know that, wouldn't you? I was able to successfully steal the Gal Bank credentials, yes.
Yes, and I heard there were no casualties. Excellent work.
So you already know.
Except for the ecliptic hit squad that you took down at the archives. I'm taking care of that mess, by the way.
What am I supposed to do, let him kill me?
Speaking of which, I assume you copied the information from the Gal Bank's computers.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see what you got. So the legacy went down at Bannock 4. Why does that sound familiar, Doft?
Bannock 4 is an EM-class gas giant, sir. There isn't a ship in the fleet that could safely get near that type of world.
Hmm. Yeah. How'd you know all that?
The Bannock system was a site of a significant battle during the Narian War.
The Narian War?
I had to do a research paper on the subject at the Academy.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I saw some kind of meme or something that... It was saying that all the really exciting stuff in Starfield happened before. Like, why can't we go through the Narian War, or I forget the other one, the big colonization, something like that. I forgot. I feel like they've hit a dead end. They need a thing for the transponder.
Good. That should slow them down for a while.
I want to ask them for this thing. They're moving faster than you think.
Look, I spend all day listening to those idiots running in circles. Are you telling me I don't know my own job?
Yeah, why not?
All right, calm down, Lieutenant.
These people are so belligerent.
Even if Delgado has an immediate solution to the EM problem, there's still the matter of tracing the Legacy's transponder signal.
Yeah. The comm spike. They think something called the comm spike will solve that problem. Can I ask these questions and then I say, are you concerned? Aren't you concerned that I'm helping them get closer to Crix's legacy?
Of course I am. We don't really have a choice in the matter. There are no shortcuts. The route you're taking to secure Crix's legacy for the Crimson Fleet is the only one at our disposal.
Mm.
You suddenly change your behavior, they'll know something's wrong. I realize it's difficult, but I urge you to stay the course for now. In the meantime, we'll formulate a plan to ensure the Crimson Fleet doesn't get their hands on that money.
I'm kind of surprised they didn't put some kind of tracer or something on my ship that they already know I'm here or something. Can't you just fly someone out there and trace it yourselves?
I'm not certain. Galbank uses their own proprietary transponder system. Even a ship as old as the Legacy would be a challenge to trace. And even if we could find the ship, we don't have anything strong enough to resist those levels of EM radiation. Unfortunately, we're hampered by the same obstacles as the Crimson Fleet.
Right. Well, they think something called a comm spike will solve that problem.
They have information about the comm spike? Damn it.
Damn it all the hell.
I'm afraid I'm not familiar with that device, sir.
Well, you don't know your job, hmm?
Shouldn't be familiar with it. It's a highly classified project. It's an advanced signal decryption and tracking device that the UC Navy's been working on for years. How the hell did the Crimson Fleet find out about that?
You got them all?
There must be an information leak somewhere, sir. It's the only thing that makes sense.
I concur.
I'll see what I can find out.
Fine. This is what we're going to do. You keep playing along and go after the comm spike.
How?
Lieutenant Doft and I will see what we can find out about Bannock 4.
How am I going to go after the comm spike? Are you any closer to convincing the Council to attack the Crimson Fleet?
My superiors are stubborn. They aren't going to authorize an attack on the Key based on my flights of fancy, I've been told. We need more evidence that all the Crimson Fleet's plans will result in them actually getting their hands on this fabled cache of credits.
Okay. Well, aren't we going to warn the UC Navy about my attempt to grab the comm spike?
I don't see the point. The Crimson Fleet apparently has a pipeline of information flowing from somewhere within the UC military. Any attempt to move the comm spike would be a waste of time. We need to play this close to the vest.
Any attempt to move the comm spike. So what am I supposed to be doing? I thought I was supposed to... Am I supposed to try to grab it? But he tells me not to move it. I'll report back with any evidence that I recover. Hopefully the quest log will tell us more info.
Perfect. Just stick with the plan and we'll see who gets to Crix's legacy first.
Well, I don't know what the plan is right now. I kinda didn't spell this out. We were supposed to get the comm spike, but we're not supposed to move it. Meet Naeva and Jasmine on the Key. I got a new mission. The best there is. Delgado has asked that I talk to Naeva and Jasmine and work out a plan to get the comm spike. Alright, so I'm just talking to them. Alright, that's still going on. Okay.
Early reports say your mission on the Siren was a success. I'm sure the commander is pleased.
Yeah, good for the commander.
Sys-Def Marines are the best of the best.
Back to the Key. Did you drop all this stuff?
Good work with the bartender. Let's see what you've got.
Was she saying something about... I mean, you still have all this stuff.
Bye for now.
Undocking. So I guess I'm heading back to the Key. So that quest is done. Okay. Very good. Okay. Well, we'll be doing that next episode. Very glad my window seems to be working fine now. No crashings. Very good. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.